Hey guys, it's Aicha. This is my FITT Sexy Back Workout. For those of you taking part in the FITT in 30 program, you're going to be doing this once a week. It's going to be all about our backs. But we're going to get some arms, we'll get some legs in there too, but the main goal is going to be we're going to target our back. We're going to do three circuits. We're going to do three strength training moves in each circuit. We'll do one cardio move, and we're going to repeat the circuit twice. It'll be fun, it'll be fast, we're burning some calories, and start strengthening our back. So with that, let's just start with a stretch. We'll do, let's do some arm circles. So arms to your side. And we're just gonna do some forward arm circles. Feet are shoulder width apart. Planted nice and grounded on the floor. And we're just circling. And I want you to circle nice and strong so that you can also stretch your obliques. Breathe in and out as you do this. Let's get the blood flowing. Few more, then we're gonna do back circles. I know you feel the stretch on your back as well, I do. All right, two more. Let's hold and let's change the direction. We're just gonna do back circles. Different move, engaging different parts of our back. Breathe in and out. Lift your arms, nice long swings. Let's do a few more here. Breathe in and out. Nice, slow, controlled movements. Let's do two more. All right, let's stretch those legs a little. Let's just jog in place. Breathe in and out. We're gonna have some fun, work on our back. Do a little bit of legs too while we're at it. As I've always said, the more body parts we use in an exercise, the more calories we burn, the quicker we get the results we wanna see. Jog it a little bit more. Then we'll just do front toe kicks. We can stretch out our hamstrings. All right, so we're gonna kind of just do a military walk. Up. Opposite arm, opposite leg. Just lift as far as you can go. You'll feel the stretch on your hamstrings, the back of your legs. We continue to stretch our arms and our back. Let's do a few more. Two more. And last one. All right, let's just do some cross jacks. Let's stretch our back a little bit more because we're gonna be working primarily on our back muscles. Breathe in and out, nice and slow. You don't need to go crazy in our warm up. Let's do a few more. Five, four, three, two, and one. All right, excellent. I'm all stretched up, hopefully you are too. We'll start with circuit one. Our first exercise is gonna be a single arm row. What you're gonna do is, now I have weights ranging from 5 to 20 pounds, but again, use the weights that you're comfortable with. If you don't have any weights, you could do the exercise without weights, and you'll be just fine. So I'm gonna pick my kettlebell, just because I like doing this exercise with a kettlebell. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna lunge out with our right leg, weight in the opposite arm. We're gonna tilt down. For beginners, keep your hand on your knee, and we're gonna just pull up. That's an upright row. All right, we're gonna do 15 reps of each exercise. And if you're a little advanced and you could do more, stick your hand out and pull. This is kind of the badass version, all right? So let's get started. I'll count off to 15. We'll do this side and we'll do the other side when we repeat the circuit. Ready? Let's go. Breathe in and out. Nice, controlled. That's 10. That's 5 more. The pressure on your glute. In that position, we're working our quads and we're working our glutes as well. Next one is a lat pull down. I'll show you the move. We're gonna grab our weights, and again, no weights, no need to use any weights at all. I've got 5 pounds, nothing crazy. Feet just hip width apart, and essentially we're gonna stick our arms out. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring them up front, up to the top, palms facing up top. Make sure you keep your hands above your head. Don't bring them out in front of you because that's a different muscle that you're working that we're not trying to work today. Breathe in and out. That's 10, five more. And one more. Alright, we're going to move on to our next move, which is the stork stance and upright row. So I'm going to show the modified version. Essentially what we're going to do is we're going to get kind of into almost like a lunge position, but so just stick your right foot forward. We're going to tilt forward a little bit. We're going to turn our weights so that your palms are facing me, and we're going to lean, put our stomach right by our lay your chest on your leg, and we're going to pull up. Up towards our shoulder, up towards our torso. Okay, we're engaging the lower part of our back right now and the upper part as well. And I want you to pull when you pull in. Really pull those weights into your torso. Engage your abs at all times. Tighten your abs. We're working our quad right now as well. And our glute as you press that foot in into the ground and you pull. Excellent. All right. We're going to go back to the beginning. Repeat the circuit. We're going to do our single arm row, opposite side. So this time, our left leg is going to go forward. Yeah. Our left leg is back. Toes are the balls on your feet. Hands down. If you're a little bit advanced and a bit stronger, you can do it this way. You do the upright row. Otherwise, put your knee on your leg. Totally fine. You're getting the same exercise. You're using your back to pull the weight up. All right. Ready? Let's go. That's 10, five more. Feeling this too. And last one. Excellent. All right, so with that, we know the next move. We're going back to our lat pull. Get your weights, put them up to the ceiling. We're gonna pull down and really pull down and use your strength so that you can use those back muscles. Last one. Excellent. Put the weights down. Grab your weights again. We're going to do a kind of stork stance with a pull to the torso, opposite side. So this time, we go forward with our left leg. Tilt a little bit, chest over your knee. Hands down, palms facing up. Pull up to the torso. Ready? Let's go. And you can look straight down, whatever makes you comfortable. You want to make sure your chest is slightly over your leg. Your head is nice and straight so that you're not bending your back or hurting yourself in any way. Pull. Getting Excellent. Excellent job, guys. We're done with our strength for circuit one. Let's do a little bit of cardio just to get our heart rate up and to keep it up there before we move to circuit two. We're going to do a running man. Essentially, kind of like getting a runner's pose. Opposite arm, opposite hand, and we're going to be just switching. Alright, we're going to do that for 30 seconds. So let's go. Give or take, it'll be about 30 of them or so. Alright? Breathe in and out. Alright, excellent. Circuit two. We're going to get to the ground. We're going to stay there for a little bit as we do circuit two. I'm going to show you the move. I'll get my weight. First thing we're going to do is a flat pull and a chest press. So, I'll show the move without weight, and then I'll show the moves with weight. We're going to lie flat on the ground, and what we're going to do, essentially, naturally we have weights. We're going to pull them up, keep them right on our chest. Do a chest press, and then back down again. Chest press, and then back down again. All right? We'll do 15 reps. I'm gonna get my weights. Again, if you don't have any weights, just do what I did. And it's just as good. Okay, for those of you with weights, let's get our hands back behind our head. On the count of three, we'll get started. One, two, three. Last three. Last two. And last one. 15. Excellent. Alright. Our next move we're gonna do is a chest fly and tricep dip. So we're gonna stay where we are. I'll show you what we're gonna do. We're gonna work our chest and also work our triceps as well. So chest fly, arms come out. That big, nice and simple. Okay, then when we come back in, we're going to work our triceps. And our elbows down, back up. So chest fly, out, and in, triceps, down, and up. Got it? We'll do 15 reps. Again, if you want to work your legs, you want to hit the mat a little bit. Tilt that pelvis up, tighten your glutes. Let's go. Squeeze your glutes if you're up here. If you've got your pelvis tilted, then use your abs. Let's try and burn as many calories as we can and each exercise and tone as much as we can. Push, push, push. And if you get tired, drop the weights down and just do the move. Two. Excellent, excellent job, guys. All right, let's get up to the ground. We are gonna move on to our next exercise, which is a chair with a reverse fly. So, I will show you the move. And again, no weights, no problem. I'll put these down, show you with no weights. We're gonna get in chair position, which essentially our feet together, sit like you sit down in the chair, and we're gonna do a reverse fly, which is just lifting our arms up and really pulling. And even if you do this without the weights, you feel your back. You feel your back just working and being engaged and tightening. So I'm gonna get my weights, nothing crazy, just 5 pounds, no weight, do the move, you will totally feel it, all right? With that, let's get into your position. Heels are back, almost looking up at the sky. Breathe in and out. Excellent. Awesome. Circuit one, circuit two done. You guys do it one more time, then we can move to circuit three. So let's get back to the ground for our chest, for our full chest, arm press, and our chest, and then we'll do our other two exercises, and then we'll be done. All right, again, if you want to work the booty a little bit, get into a good position. Hands up. We're going to do our left pull and chest press. Ready? Let's go. Stay right there, don't go anywhere. We are doing our chest fly and tricep dip. Again, stay in bridge position. If you're tired, you need to rest down, come on down. Otherwise, stay up there, tighten your glutes. Let's go. Make sure your heels are nicely flat on the ground, your back is arched. We want to make sure we prevent any sort of injury. A few more to go. Three more. And last one. Excellent. Excellent job, guys. We're going to do cardio for circuit two. Move on to circuit three. We're almost done. Get more than we need to. More cardio is going to be mountain climbers. We're going to get to the ground. I'll show you what we need to do. Essentially, we're going to be in plank position, back nice and straight, and we're literally just pulling our legs in and out, okay? So, modified version, just do this, advance, run it out, all right? Do that for about 20 seconds, let's go. Keep your abs nice and tight. Almost there. Excellent. Let's get up. Last circuit. You guys are doing awesome. I'm with it too. I'm gonna dry out. You guys know me, I'm always sweating like crazy. We're gonna do our last circuit. And then we'll be done. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do what's called a sword lunge. We're gonna do a lunge. Come up, like with the lead, raising the sword. I'm going to use weights, but I'll show you the move that a little bit, okay? So lunge, and back up. Back up. Back up. So you're working your legs, and we're working our back as we pull the arms back up with or without a weight, okay? So let's start with our left. We'll do our right the second time around. Weight to your side, arm to your side. If you're more comfortable with your arm down here, totally fine. Let's go. Make sure you look at me as you lunge down. Push your butt back. Excellent job, guys. Almost there. Here's 10. 5 more to go. Last one. Excellent. All right, let's move on to our next move, which is literally just a bent upright row. We're gonna get into stand, feet width apart. We're gonna bend down, and we're gonna row with our palms facing front this time. Last time we did our palms facing up. We're gonna do our palms facing front, which engages a different muscle on our back. Tilt our knees very slightly, arch your back, and we're just gonna pull up. All right, so get ready. We'll do 15 of those on count. Just up. Don't forget to breathe. Alright guys, again get more if you need it. We've got one more exercise to go. We'll repeat the circuit, we'll do our cardio, then we'll be done. We're going to do a squat thrust into the plank jack. Alright, we're going to use our upper body, using our abs, engage our core as well as we do the squat thrust. Let me show you, we're going to get back down to the ground. Plank position. Dropping into a little wall. Just in and out, and then plank jack and in. Got it? Modified version, in, out, out, jack, 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 jack. Got it? Let's go. We're gonna do just for a few seconds, all right? Engage your core, let's go.
yourself, guys. This is towards the end. I know you're tired. You can do it. Just push. We've got a few more minutes to go. Let's do five more. Drenched as usual. Where's my towel? I can't find my damn towel. Oh, here it goes. All right. Wipe off, get some water. We have one more circuit. Repeat this one, then we're done. All right. Take a water break when you need to. And for some of the exercises, if you feel you can't do it, just march in place. It's totally fine. March in place, get a breather, and get back into it. All right, so we're gonna go back to the exercise. Let's do our bent row with an upright row. Slight bent knees, tilt a little bit, palms facing forward, and pull up. Breathe in and out. Let the heart rate go down a little bit. Drop all the way down. We're going back to our sword lunge. Opposite leg. So let's do the left leg and bring our right arm back up. All right? Ready? Let's go. And as you go down, sit back into that glute. Use your legs, your glute muscle. Great job, guys. It's 10, 5 more to go. Plus 2. Last 1. Excellent. Awesome. One more move, and we're going to stretch. We've got a squat thrust to plank. This is a nice cardio move. Working every single muscle in your body. Let's get down to the ground, do that last move, and we are done. All right, last position. Again, modified version, in, up, out, jack, 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 jack. Advance. All right, ready? Let's go, guys. Doing this, you're gonna be winded just as I am. So Your body will get used to it as you do it over and over again each week. Keep in mind, it'll take time to transform, and we need to do a different group of exercises. That's why, you know, one day we do cardio, one day we do upper body, lower body, back, and we'll eventually get you to the fitness level you need to get into. All right, let's just stretch our arms. Let's do just overall. Pull your arms in and out. Take a deep breath. Let our heart rate come down. We're gonna swing our arms, then we're gonna do our shoulder stretch. Can't forget to speak. On three. One, two, and hold your elbow. Look to the right. To the left, sorry. Jesus, you're tardy today. All right, feel that stretch. Let's stretch our triceps. Did a little bit of tricep work as well. Still a little bit. Let's get that oblique. We're inclined quite a bit, all those squat thrusts and plank jacks. All right, let's swing our arms, get the other side. One, two, and three. Pull your elbow, look to the right. Stretch our tricep a little bit. Okay, let's do our usual tilt. Stretch our obliques. Excellent, let's clasp our fingertips behind our backs. Let's look to the ceiling and stretch our chest. We did some chest flies, some chest presses. Okay, bring your hands in front of you, clasp your fingertips, push out. Let's stretch that back that we worked so hard on today. You can look up, you can look straight out, push out. Excellent. We also worked our legs a little bit, so let's do our regular quad stretch. Knee to knee. Pull down. Push your heel into your butt. Feel the stretch right on your quadricep. Other side. Knee to knee. Stretch that quad. Great job, guys. I'm so proud of you. Stick with this, and I promise you will get results. You know, hopefully you're having fun. I love working out. I have fun when I work out. You know, that's the start of it. Let's stretch our hamstrings a little bit. Knee front, hand on the balls of your foot. Push back a little bit. Feel that stretch on your hamstring. Don't pull too hard. Let's do the other side. Then let's stretch that out a little bit. And that's it, done. You're good to go. Start your day, do whatever it is that you gotta do for the rest of the day. Hope you had fun. Stick with this workout, stick with the program, and you'll see results. Thanks, guys. Bye.